Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am filming a first impressions on the Milani stick foundation. This is the Conceal and Perfect foundation stick in the shade 265 Natural Tan. I picked this up online as well as their Conceal and Perfect longwear concealer, and this is in the shade 145 Warm Beige and a few other new Milani products. I accidentally deleted my intro to this video, so I am filming this on a different day, and I'm so sorry about that. But without further blabbering, let's get into the demo of some of these new Milani products. Okay guys, so let's get to it. I want to try out the Milani Conceal and Perfect Stick Foundation. I have the actual liquid foundation somewhere in my makeup collection. So I'm just curious to try this, and I thought it would be fun to film like a how it goes on, kind of like a first impressions, because I've been saving this to film with, and I think the shade's gonna be a decent match. This is 265 Natural Tan, and I ordered this online, but you know, I've noticed that like my Walmart's really picked up, and they've stocked a lot of the new Milani stuff as well as a lot of the new Wet n Wild stuff. So if you guys are looking for a drugstore, check your local Walmart. So this one reminds me kind of the Wet n Wild stick foundation. It's very thick and it's hard to spread. So that's why I thought I should use a beauty blender, because it is damp. It just makes it easier for me to, you know, make sure it's blended. And I don't have any eyeshadow on yet, so I'm just gonna apply this to my whole face. I didn't think my hair would get in the way as much as it is. If you guys didn't know, I did cut my hair a couple of inches off because I think I'm destined to be a short hair girl. I just find it so unmanageable. So I'm sure because of my lights and stuff, my skin probably looks pretty flawless, because it usually always does on camera. My skin's been so dry this winter. Right here, it's like my problem areas. I feel like my mouth is so discolored around there. Definitely didn't cover up like my dark circles or anything. But what is this, like $10, this foundation? I'm not really a huge stick foundation person either. So I also wore the ColourPop one the other day to work. It was okay. Just been wanting to try all the affordable stick foundations, I guess. I feel like it's not emphasizing, but it's not really like making me look extra smooth or anything like that. Definitely doesn't give me like any hydration or anything, in case any of you guys are curious about that. But okay, so I basically did like a second layer around my mouth and stuff, and then I want to try the concealer, because I do have the concealer as well, and I picked this up in the shade 145. It was so hard to pick a color online. Oh my gosh. But like I said, my Walmart has these concealers in stock too. So if the Walmart and Fargo can get it together, I'm sure your guys as well too. This is a beautiful packaging. Kind of looks like the Jeffree Star liquid lipstick packaging, just a little bit longer. Nice little doe foot. This feels nice and creamy. I love how it's like gliding on. It's very wet feeling, which I like. Because the, because the foundation stick was very dry feeling. So hopefully this will give me some extra coverage. I've heard mixed reviews on this. I feel like, actually, I've heard most people say they didn't like this foundation. So, I mean, this concealer. So I'm curious if I will also dislike it or like it. I down. I think I just did away with my brows. JK, they're just full of concealer and foundation, which is fine. Ooh, I really thought I felt I liked that concealer better than the foundation for sure. Have you guys tried this foundation? I would be so curious to know what you guys think about it. Okay, I'm done pouncing. My hand's starting to hurt. So there's that. You guys are like zoomed in, so you should be seeing pretty clear on the screen. And I do want to try out their bronzer. I picked this up from the website as well. This is the shade Sun Drenched. It's the darkest color. I thought it looked so dark, but I put this in a haul. When I held it up on screen, it didn't do so dark, so I forgot to set my face. Oh, geez. I'll set it after I bronze. It's fine. This brush, if you're wondering, I got this like last year. This is the Real Techniques Instapop Face Brush. It has like this angled cut to the bristles. Kind of like it. I really like this one. There's a blush version. I really like it for blush. And so I don't really contour anymore. So I'm just giving myself a healthy bronzed look. I have a feeling there's a little too much red in this bronzer for me. I might look a little weird, guys. Sorry. I don't know. This side of my face looks kind of funny in the mirror. I don't know. You guys tell me. I'm going to set with the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish powder. I love this powder so much. I seriously am contemplating just getting rid of all my other powders because this one just stays put. I like that it's a pressed powder. And I was using a Morphe R5 to apply that. So I'm gonna go in with this first. This is the Coral Beams Coral Harmony blush. And it's like a mix of colors. So I'm just taking a Real Techniques brush. I bought this in California. You guys seeing any color on my face? I don't know. I guess I can kind of see it. Let's try this one. This is their Luminous Glow Shimmering Face Palette. So beautiful. Sorry, my lights maybe. Oops, I just lost the insert. Just going into the pink section. Ooh, this is glowy. Do you guys see that? So I can even use this big old brush in there, but I am mixing shades. Ooh, I like that. Okay, here is my highlighter brush that I've been loving, Morphe M438. It's a little bit denser of a brush. Just going into this section here, see what kind of highlight. Ooh, I love Milani's highlighters. Milani and Wet n Wild at the drugstore. Always killing it. Oh, yes. Yas, queen. I like to put some highlight on my brow bones too. Okay. We are dripping. We are sipping. Okay. I am going to do my eyes and come back and just kind of give you guys my thoughts, but I want to spray my face down with this Milani Make It Last setting spray. I am almost out of this. So excited. Trying to use up my makeup, guys. Did I just finish it? Oh no, there's lip. So affordable, cutest packaging, so great for traveling. So these are all the Milani face products I wanted to try out. I will put my brows on, put a lippy on, eyeshadow on, and I will be right back. So this is the final look, and I have been wearing this foundation now for a little bit. I love the convenience of a stick foundation. This is definitely not my favorite formula for a stick foundation. It was very drying, it's definitely a more matte foundation in my opinion. I do like the shade. I think it's a good match for me. This has an 18-month shelf life and you do get 0.46 ounces of product. I do find that stick foundations, you don't go through them that quickly. So I remember when the Hourglass stick foundation came out, everyone was like freaking out because they thought, you know, you were getting gypped because there wasn't a whole lot of product. But personally, I don't think that's an issue. Price point is okay. I'm of course used to like spending like under $5 when it comes to drugstore. I do understand Milani is a little bit more expensive, and I did end up ordering these online because I didn't think I would be able to find them in my drugstore, but I have seen these in quite a few drugstores, so make sure you go ahead and check there. So it was okay. I'm gonna give this like a 5 out of 10. Definitely not my favorite. I did like the concealer quite a bit. I like this packaging. I like how wet it was. It was like more liquidy, which was nice because I was kind of expecting this to be very drying. It does say on here this is a long wear concealer and this one has a 12-month shelf life. I will let you guys know, I've only probably had this on for about a half an hour to maybe an hour. So I will wear this the rest of the day and leave my thoughts on these products in the description box, just so if anything changes or I notice anything weird as time goes on, I will let you know those things. I think Milani makes amazing face products. This is a beautiful face palette, and I think this is a little bit pricey, so I don't love that, but you do get quite a few shades. Instead of buying just like one product, there are 8 shades in here, so that's kind of nice, and it's kind of very high-end looking, so that is really nice from Milani as well. And then, of course, I did try the bronzer, and I don't think it looks as bad as when I first put it on. I was worried that it was kind of red. Is this my favorite bronzer formula? Definitely not. I feel like there are some products from Milani that are like my holy grail, like their highlighters I love so much. But this one, it was okay. I feel like they can do better. I think I like the Maybelline bronzer that I've been trying recently a lot better than this one. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Everything else is kind of products I've always had. I did also add this lipstick. This is the Super Bloom Velvet Blur from ColourPop. I just thought this would be a fun pop of color with the eye look I have going on. And the eye look is my first impression of the Violet Voss Sugar Crystal palette. So if you're interested in seeing that, this video is probably up already because this is a newer product, and I will link it in the eye for you guys so you can check it out. Other than that, this is everything. Let me know your thoughts on Milani down below, and I will catch up with you guys in my next video. Bye!